Hello everyone, I welcome you all to this 30 days masterclass series on electric vehicle design. Today is day 22. We are going to discuss about the powertrain model with different configurations. I welcome you everyone here. Yes, warm welcome participants. I welcome Aditya, Vijayendra, Ramathurai, XYZ, ABZ, Yogendra, warm welcome participants, Abhinash, Tushar, Srinivasa, Srivatsa, Karthik, Akshay Kumar. Very good evening everyone here. Am I audible participant? So please comment. Am I audible? Kubernath. Hello Karthik, hello. Yes, am I audible? Can you please comment in the comment box? Deepali, Busha, Vashant Kumar, hi. Yes, Siddharth, Ratna Raju, very good evening. Jubair, Chota, Behra, Prakash, Lemonsu, Anju Begum, yes, thank you participants, thanks for your comment. Yes, about the Pantech is an educational equipment manufacturing company. From Pantech you can get lab equipments for EEE, ECE, computer science, IT and AI related products, you can get it. About the vision, so to help 10 million students to learn the technology in easy way, so far we have trained about 1.5 lakh students. So this year we have targeted 10 million students to learn this in very easy way. So regarding this, we have scheduled a few more masterclass series like IoT and the data science also. So if you are interested, so please keep watch with this our sessions, and you can get the registration link from here. Just visit our YouTube channel. And so in the community page you can identify the classes. So Pantech e-learning, just visit the our website. Yeah, see here the community page, you can get, yes, so you can get a registration link. So if you are interested, so please watch this, get enrolled with this event. Yes. And so you have announcement 7:30 PM. We will share you the attendance form. So please don't forget to submit the attendance form. And you have to submit 25 days attendance to get a webinar's participation certificate. And till 16th, you can join in the batch 4EV. Yes. And so far we have covered about motor control, battery sections and basic models. So now we are into powertrain modeling, day 22nd. See here we are into powertrain modeling. Yes, so powertrain modeling. So under this we are going to discuss various aspects like gearing mechanisms. Yesterday we have covered the brake mechanisms. So have you participated, have you practiced this braking mechanisms with MATLAB Simulink? So can you please comment, have you practiced the brake experiment? Yes. So have you practiced the brake experiment as per the previous class? Surab Modi, please don't make videos private. No. See, actually after the live, the video will be moved to the private mode. So you please rewatch the video within 3 days. Yes, thank you participants. Swarup, Ratna Raju, Busha, Vashant Kumar, great, Ramadurai. Data sheet is available on the internship portal. So please watch the internship portal. Yes, great. Low, Yeah, Maya, thank you, participants. So others, those who are all not practiced, so please practice this thing. Mr. Surab Modi, if you are the internship user, so you can join in the internship and you can get all the stuff. You can watch all the videos at any point of time. MATLAB master class is a different channel, so it's a Pantech solution channel, so please check with that channel, right? So that is our that is one more team from our company. I have joined internship. How can I see day two videos and other videos? So please watch the internship portal. In the YouTube it's not available, so please watch the internship portal. That is the LMS portal. Yes, very good evening, Swapnil. Yes, so others, please practice the experiment, whatever we shared in the live class. So please practice it. So now we are going to discuss about from the previous day classes, previous day examples. So now we are going to use two different ideal source. With that source, we are going to excite the vehicle. So actually in the previous day example, we have used free body diagram and a slope angle we have used to drive the vehicle, right? Similarly, we are going to remove the slope angle. So just we are going to keep the vehicle on the flat surface road. Now we are going to excite the vehicle with the ideal, just ideal power source, like angular velocity source as well as the torque source. Those components are available in the MATLAB. So which means that we can ensure that our vehicle can respond for the any movement. Right? So please watch the class and keep engaged with the entire class. And after that, we are going to design a multi-speed like a gear mechanisms. Even though the VE electric vehicle is not required the gear mechanisms, so still you can go with the gear also, right? Now there is no any limitations whether you should know, you should go exactly with without gear or with gear. So in the EV you have an option to go with without gear also, since it's a power direct drive systems, right? And in this example, the gear system, why I have included the sense, you should know how to gear mechanism is working in the MATLAB. So in that aspect I have included this one. And similarly, finally we can once all the verifications done, then we can calculate the motor power, and that the same motor power can be connected to the electric can be connected to the vehicle body. So and after that we will excite the motor. So how much motor power is required and how we can derive the those things, everything we can integrate with the DC motor, right? So is it clear? So about the today topic, so are you ready to learn the concepts? If you are ready, please comment the comment box ready. So here I have used to reduce the speed purpose, the gear mechanisms. Yes. So if you are ready, please comment the comment box ready so that we can move forward. Yes. Thank you. Great. Yeah. Yes. Okay, great. Fine. So let's move to the next one. And see, actually, as per our previous sections, so I'm going to take a previous classes. Yes. See, actually, here yesterday we decided, yesterday we have verified this, this is the powertrain terrain data. So this has been introduced to drive the vehicle. So now we are going to just leave this one. Simply we are going to connect a 0 degree, right? So just apply 0 degree here. So which means that our vehicle is going to be in a flat surface. So now we have to add the drive system in the rear wheel or front wheel systems, right? So now we are going to include this in the front wheel drive system. So straight away we are going to connect the vehicle drive source to the wheel. So let us check how the vehicle can be working, right? So these are all the brakes. So let us apply this brake at a different level. So initially we have applied just 20 seconds and then 25 seconds. So now let us run the vehicle for 100 seconds. So in that case, first gear we can apply at 75 seconds, and then second brake we can apply about 85 seconds or 90 seconds, right? So first variations is this brake mechanisms, and now we are going to just move the vehicle with the power source. Camera on voice is breaking. My God. Actually, from here there is no any issue. Okay. Ooh, everything is perfect. My voice is audible. Still, is it breaking? So let us remove the image so that you won't feel about the break. Is my am I audible? Is still my voice is breaking? Is still my voice breaking? Can you please comment? I have removed my image. Okay, thank you Hariharan. So now I just remove my image. So whenever I switch to the presentations, I will display my screen. Yeah, thank you. Yes, thank you Rigvith Sharma. So now let us change the let us include the ideal angular velocity source. See here, I just take this one, ideal angular velocity source. So just to add, simply we are going to drive with the manual connections, right? So manually we are trying to just push the vehicle by this one. Take a reference, mechanical rotational reference. Just to connect, and here only we are going to apply a manual input. So just to take a Simulink to PS converter. And take a constant block. So via this constant block, we are going to apply a value. Right. See here, we are going to apply the radian per second value. So this is since it's an angular velocity source. So straight away, this value, whatever you are applying, so the same value, that is that equivalent RPM should reach. It's not RPM, it's a radian per second. So in that case, we can measure the, kilometer per hour. Right. So this is the kilometer per hour value. So now let us check. Just run this simulation. So since we have applied one value, so let's check how this is responding. Yeah, see here, that is a 0.2522. yeah, so the vehicle has started. So now just to increase the value, so about 750 radian per second. So let us take 750 radian per second. So I choose this just as a random value. So you can keep whatever you want. Just we are going to verify whether our vehicle is going to run or not. Yeah. See here so the vehicle has started to run. So this vehicle is rotating at 30 radian per second, 30 kilometer per hour. And at 90th instant, we have applied one brake. 75 and then 90. Yes. So still, if the kilonewton is not enough, so just increase, try to increase this value so that you can see the brake, whether the perfectly it's applied or not. Right. Yes. So still it needs more braking mechanisms. So like that we can include another one. So this is the ideal angular source. Similarly, we have an ideal torque source also. So actually the both are different. See here the torque as well as the ideal angular velocity, which means that just a second, I will give you the information. So earlier we have used ideal angular velocity, now we are going to use ideal torque source. See, actually the ideal angular velocity will give you will generate a differential velocity. That is, it generates a velocity difference at its terminal. See, the motor terminal, it will give you the different velocity. Similarly, the ideal torque source, actually in the MATLAB, in the MATLAB, we are going to see the difference one, right? See here, this is the angular velocity. Similarly, we can take ideal torque source. So just to take ideal torque source. Yeah. See here, if you measure the torque value, whatever we applied here, so the torque value for this reference speed, the torque has been generated. Suppose if you use this, then whatever the torque is constant, whatever we are applying the torque value, so that is a required value. By default, suppose if you are applying a motor, so in the motor we cannot feed the direct value torque, right? So we know the voltage of the motor. If you change the voltage, then we can adjust the speed of the motor. So indirectly, if you know the motor power, then we can calculate how much torque can be delivered by the motor. Right. So now we can estimate how much torque we need to rotate at the same speed. So just to remove this one. Yes, just to remove this. Okay, my system is little bit slow. Still voice breaking is experience. So try to manage this one. So now we are going to use the torque source. So before that, we can measure the torque sensor. So just take ideal torque sensor. Yes. Just connect as per this one and take PS to Simulink converter. So this is the torque value, so which it is generated by the system, right? So now this much amount amount of torque is required to run this vehicle at a desired speed. See here. This is the torque value which is developed by the system, and even though actually see here at the 75th instant we have applied the brake, right, to stop the motor. So in that case the torque again it has increased. Similarly this also actually at 90th instant also we have applied to increase the to apply the brake. So during that system also the torque has been increased, that is the changes of the torque. Similarly if you change the value, right, see instead of ideal velocity source just to use the ideal torque source, ideal torque source, just to rotate it. So if you apply 40 Newton meter, 40 or 50 or whatever you want, you can take it. So now let us check how this motor vehicle is responding. Yeah, so we achieve the same speed and the torque. Now this will be a, yes, yes, so this is the ideal torque source. So whatever we apply, the same torque has been applied. So now let us check this one. See here, due to that constant torque, earlier the torque is not a constant, it's a variable one. So now we have applied the constant torque requirement. So due to this, see here, before that one, the source has been varied. So now the point is, from this experiment you can understand how much torque is required to drive your vehicle on perfect manner. So in that case you should know the motor power rating and then torque rating, right? So is it clear? Is it clear? So and again, see actually since this experiment, these blocks are looks like a complex components, so I'm going to consider this as a subsystem. So let us take all these things in the subsystem. So just to create Control G, so this is called a subsystem, and similarly this is the braking mechanisms, right? So this is the braking mechanisms. So let us consider this is the braking mechanisms. So this is the brake system. And similarly this is the vehicle model. So this is the vehicle model. Vehicle model. And this is the output of the vehicle. Thank you participants. Just use Control G to create a subsystem. So now you can change the parameters of this one also. So see here, you can use these commands to change the see here, so no need to see the content preview. So in that case you can you can uncheck it, then the block will be there, and you can use any other images also. So in that case you can use the mask system to change that one. And here you can create a mask and all. So you can add icon image, so whatever you can use that image you can use it. So like that you can check, you can create whatever you have actually. Yes. So like that, you can add your own image. Right. So now we are going to introduce the brake, I mean gear mechanisms, right? So for that one, see, this is the two different level of speed. Similarly, we are going to use three different speed mechanisms. So for the three different speed mechanisms, I have already developed this project. Yes. Yes. See here, the three level of speed. So first we have to develop this mechanisms like a three different level. If you apply a one radian per second speed, so that speed should be divided by three. So this is a half of one third, and then first one equal speed, and then 2/3. So like this, 3/2. So this is 2/3, and then this is 3 equal to 3, and then one. And then this is a 3/2. So like that, we have to change the speed. So for that one, so first we should know how to differentiate this signal. See here, the how to differentiate the signal in the sense. So just to take, I'm going to create a new block. Just use new model. If you feel this video is lagging, so please adjust. Actually, now in between, I cannot do anything. So try to manage these things. So I'm going to take first a signal builder. So I'm going to take just a signal builder. So now up to 30 seconds, we are going to divide this three different levels. So in that case, just use change time range. So we are going to implement a three gear system. First gear for 10 seconds, second gear for 10 to 20 seconds, and third gear for from 20 seconds to next 30 seconds. So I'm going to extend this signal from 30 different signals. So adjust this one. So just exact at 20 and 10. 0 to 10, adjust this value like this, 10 and 20. Similarly, just to change the Y display limits from minus 1 to Y values, right? So this is 1 and so this is 4. So which means that three signals we are going to get it. So just change to 3. Yes, and change to 3, and similarly adjust this. So now, which means that till 0 to 10 seconds, first gear will enable. From 10 to 20, second gear will enable. From 20 to 30, third gear will enable. So now we have to separate this three signals into individual seconds. So in that case, so now let us check the output. Take a scope block, whether are we getting the proper signal or not, right? So just run this signal, run this simulation for 100 seconds. Just run this for 100 seconds. Slightly there is a difference, so we have to adjust the value still. Yes, and now we have to slightly adjust this one. See here. Three, And similarly here also we have to apply 3. So now you just run this one, we can get a proper output. Yes. See here, 10 seconds first gear, 10 to 20 seconds second gear, and after that the third gear. So like that we will apply a vehicle. Whatever you are generating the speed, the same speed will be modified as per this one. So now let us take an angular velocity source. Ideal angular velocity source. Just to take this one. And take a constant. Just to take a constant one and take a symlink to PS converter. Just to take a symlink to PS converter. So which means that so this is the once radian per second. This is going to apply with different gear levels, right? So just to take a mechanical rotational reference. Yes. So now we can take a clutch, right? So that clutch we have to modify, use it. So just to take clutch, C-L-U-T-C-H. Disc friction clutch. See here, so there are the three different pins. So which means that whatever you are applying the speed, this speed will be transferred whenever the pressure signal is high, right? So this port, the P port, whenever the P port P exceeds the engagement threshold pressure, right? The signal port, physical signal port, P exceeds the engagement pressure threshold pressure. So in that case, the same speed whatever available at the B, so this will be transferred at the output port, right? So from here we can add the gear mechanisms. So So just to take gearbox. Just a second, it will take some time. I think I have chosen the missing, faulty component. Yes. So just to take a simple gearbox. Just to take a simple gear and apply here. So which means that first gear is the very low speed. So this will be 3/2. Right. So this is the very lowest speed. And after that, here we have to apply a same speed. So without a gear we can take it. So this is the another one, right? And after that just separate the speed. So this is the high speed, right? So here we have to take, here we have to apply 2/3, right? So the 2/3 value is very low. So that is the low one. So this is 3/2. This is 3/2. And this is 2/3. And connect accordingly. So here we have to generate a control signal. So this P signal we have to apply whenever the pressure is high. So I mean greater than the threshold value. So this clutch will get enabled, right? So from this from this gearbox, so from this three different control signal we have to derive this one. So let us take, this is a low and this is a medium. This is medium and this is high. Okay, so now we have to develop a logic to separate where it is, how long this signal is 1 and how long the signal is 2, how long the signal is 3, right? So for that one, just to take a compare signal. So the compare signal is, so since it's a constant value, you can take a compare signal. So just to take a compare, there will be a, compare to 0, compare to constant. So just to take a compare to constant. So first, if you take a equal to, yes. So if it is equal to 1, then this will enable high, right? So this will enable high. Similarly, if it is a 2, if it is a 2, then during this period only, this will give you a high value. So see here, so this is the low. If the signal comes here, then this block will be enabled. This block will be enabled during this period only alone, and this block will enabled during the second gear block. Similarly, we have to generate a third gear. Just to change it to third. So this is simple logic. So actually, as per my requirement, I have developed. So whatever you want, you can choose whatever there. And let us connect this one, right? So here, and again, we have to apply a physical signal. So in that physical signal, generally we have to apply via the constant one. Okay. So let us take a. So let us take a switch case. Yes. So by default, during this period, this block will enable high. So which means that above 0, right? So in that case, we have to apply a high value. So let us take a pressure. Just we are going to ensure the pressure. So like you just imagine how much pressure you are going to apply for in your real-time vehicle. So in the clutch pedal, right? So just to take a constant block. So here just apply 1000 value. So I'm going to keep it maximum value. Similarly, this is the minimum value. So here rest of the period will be 0. Right? So if it is 0, then this clutch will not work. So in that case, the pressure will not, the speed will not transfer to the gear mechanisms. Yes, is it clear? So can you, if you have any questions, you please comment. Is it clear? If you have any questions, you please comment so that I can answer your questions. Just I'm rearranging this one. So just to create, this is such a simple subsystem. So now we have to connect this one. So since it's a Simlink signal, then this is the Simscape signal. So we have to take Simlink to Simscape converter. Right. So just create as a subsystem, this three model. Just to create subsystem. Yes, right. So now you can connect here. Similarly, just to take the same logic. So just connect accordingly. Just take. Right. If you have any questions, you please comment here. So now this is the H port. So we are going to measure at here. So just to take, add the inertia block to fix the here. Yes. Similarly, we are going to take a sensor that is ideal rotational motion sensor. Just to take, so the rotational motion sensor will help you to sense the angular velocity. Ideal rotational motion sensor, right? Just to connect. the basic systems needs to be there to just to connect. So simple ideal source we are going to connect it here, and so reference we have to take it. Just mechanical rotational reference. See, just to take this as a reference signal. And in between damper we have to apply. So it's a open ended system. So we have to apply a damper. So just to take a rotational damper. So from here we can measure the velocity of the speed. So just take a Simlink PS2 Simlink converter. PS2 Simlink converter. And take a scope. Similarly, this is the after the after the gear, right? So before the gear also we should know, then only we can compare the speed whether our gear system is properly running or not. And take a reference. So just to take a scope block, just to take a scope block, and this is the before the gear and after the gear. And then gear input. So this gear input we have to take, right? So just add the PS solver configuration. Just add the solver configuration. Yes. Right, so now let us try to run this one. So this is very simple gear mechanisms. So we are going to test. So once if this block is completely running, then we can take as a we can create as a subsystem, and then we can directly connect to the main system. Just to change this one, these signals. Yes. So now I have missed some value. Yes. So here the three speed should be there. So input speed, this is the output speed. So the speed rotation has been changed. PF 3/2. Okay, right. So here the same direction as per the input. So just to change it, same directions. Yeah, here the three different speed is there. So just to change the value. 2 by 3, 3 by 2, and yes. So you can program whatever you want based on this one. So simply based on this control signal, the gear has been changed. Yeah. See, this is the input speed and this is the output controlled speed. Right. So like that, you have to develop your gear mechanism. So once if you know the gear mechanisms, then we can add the same gear mechanism and then we can get a multi different speed. Right. So, and after that, I have included these things. And so now we are going to add this one with a different ideal speed. See here, I have modeled. So the same logic I have modeled. So this is the general vehicle model as well as that brake model, and then this is the gear mechanism. So here the inside, so the same logic whatever I have developed, so the same logic I have used. So now if you run this one, you can get at three different speeds. So this is the gear one, then gear two, and then gear three. So this three different speed with a different braking mechanism. So at see here, the first gear, first brake has been applied at 50th instant, 50th seconds instant, and 75th second instant. Right, so the two braking mechanism. So now we have developed the ideal drive mechanism. So now we have to replace this source. So we have to replace this source with the DC motor. So as we know, how to model the DC motor with the Simscape, right? So as you know, how to model this DC motor with the Simscape. See here, I took this is another example. Yeah. So the same experiment with a different input. So I have removed all the ideal sources. So this is the actual source which we are going to use it. As per the calculations, see the motor weight is about 370 kilogram, 317 kilogram. And 1 to 1.5 meter area, that is the width and the height. Similarly, rolling resistance, whatever we developed. So the power rating is about 1.5 kilowatt. So in that case, we can take a DC motor as a 2 kilowatt. In that mode, we can take DC motor power rating is of 2 kilowatt. And then RPM is, that is that no load RPM is 750 RPM, and then rated speed is that is the fully loaded. So in that case, 500 RPM, right? So now we are extracting the physical signal. So here we are applying an electrical voltage, electrical signal, and with the help of this motor, we are generating the mechanical signal. So this mechanical signal A is transferred via the A and converted to the hub, vehicle hub. See here, then this power is connected with the rear axle. So this power is connected with the rear axle, right? So this rear axle, so you, whatever you want, you can connect either front or rear, you can connect. So if you connected to the rear one, then this is the rear mechanic, rear wheel drive. If you connect to the front one, then this is the front wheel guided vehicle. Right, so all the things are been constant. So if you apply the motor, see here we have applied 100 voltage DC voltage, constant DC voltage source, and then DC motor just simply applied, and we can get a variable speed. So whatever we took from the ideal source, the same kind of performance we can take it from here. Right, so three different speed, and now the point is you have to introduce the power electronic circuit. As per our previous learning experience, we have to include the power electronic circuit to control the motor, right? So this is the raw just control DC motor connected via the gear system to the vehicle. Is it clear? So can you please comment? Is it clear? So can you please comment? What is the use of damper? See, actually, that is the open source physical system. So in that case, damper nothing but, see, simply you cannot hold the motor in your raw hand. So you have to mount the motor on the perfect bed. So similar kind of mechanism is available on the mechanical things. So for that only we are using the damper as well as the inertia. So now can you able to add a power electronics controller circuit like a single quad, I mean four quadrant chopper to the motor to vary the motor speed? Thank you participants. So like that you have to implement your electric vehicle systems. So in the internship portal, I have given all the individual like examples. See here the example with the basic ideal power source and then ideal torque source. Example two, ideal torque source and then gear system alone. And then I gear with three different speed, ideal torque source. And then DC motor with the three different speed. So all the examples are available with the half car model complete data. So I recommend you everyone. So please visit the LMS portal and try to download the portal from the portal and then practice it. Yes, in variable speed, we have to control the DC motor by implementing the power electronics. Because what can you do to increase my utterance? Mr. Rigved Sharma, if you are an internship people, no need to worry about the utterance form. Because based on your video watch, we will capture your utterance. What is the load in case of EV? The load is you have to increase the weight. See here, as per our previous things, the rider mass as well as the vehicle mass, right? So the rider mass you have to increase it. So in the vehicle body. Yes, any more doubt? Thank you, Reshma. Thank you, Lokesh. Thank you, Suprita. Thank you, Ramadurai. Thank you, Ahmed. Now you can ask your questions. Now you can ask your questions. If you have any questions, you please ask me. I will try to give you the answers. Thank you, Shaleen. No doubt, sir. Thank you, Ratna Raju. So if you feel in Tamil Nadu, no subsidy for EV buying, Ramadurai. That's the government issue. Thank you, Cherry. Why we add mechanical blocks? So to understand the basic concepts, we can understand from the basic mechanical blocks only. Thank you, Abhinash. So if you feel this Asya, if you feel this class give you some idea about the vehicle modeling, so please share your video feedback to my WhatsApp number. For EV charging, that is entirely different, separate topic. Do you have any document with respect to design consideration for EMC on powertrains? EMC consideration only for the powertronic as of this agenda. It's a common for the electronic circuits. So in the powertrain, we are going to connect the power E motor with the vehicle. Can we add special purpose machines instead of conventional DC motor? Yeah, of course you can add the BLDC motor. All two wheeler producing in Tamil Nadu. Okay. Yeah, actually Coimbatore is going to become a hub for the electric vehicle. Rakesh, I have joined internship batch 3, but I'm not able to access my video content. So first you have to join in the you have to log into our website. Just visit our website, Pantech e-learning. So just log in here and go to your dashboard. So there will be a enrolled courses. So you just click the courses, then you can access it. Can you do the simulation with only one clutch? Yeah, of course, it's your wish. Who to get MATLAB simulation? So the MATLAB simulation, the internship people can get the MATLAB simulations. Please show how to download PDF. The PDF, you can download it, not a PDF, the presentation files and then MATLAB simulation files, you can download it from our LMS portal. What is the use of damper? See, the damper is assume that is a bed for the motor. While you design your EV motor, then you have to consider the EMC issues. While you design the powertronic circuit, you can consider the EMC problem. Which will be the EV hub according to you? See here, maybe the Pune is going to be a next hub for all the multi-vehicle systems. A two-wheeler, so far the Coimbatore already occupied the market. Yes, Mr. Yokesh, you can add the special machines also. If I watch full video, the video is not showing completed. No need to worry about Mamata Street. See here, the attendance, actually since it's a 30 days program, so far we have uploaded 21 day classes only, right? So whenever if you complete today, then tomorrow I am going to add another video. In that case, your complete button will not be available on this code website. So in that case, it will show you some error also, so you don't worry about that one. Your attendance will be marked, just watch the video, that's enough. The internship, see here, why we are telling this as an internship, in the sense, this is not a traditional course. Simply, I'm just learning, I'm just throwing away some content and then just you are hearing those content. So it's not a traditional courses. See here, I have given you the recorded classes. So we are pressurizing you to practice all the experiments, right? So this is 30 days learning behavior. If you finish, if you perfectly watch 45 minutes per day with 30 days for 30 days period of time, then definitely you can get a complete idea about the electric vehicle systems, right? So this kind of facility we are giving you, and similarly at the same time we are keep on alerting you to access all the contents and that. Right, so this kind of based on this setup only we are calling this is a internship portal, and our charge is again only for whatever we are giving you the services like online portal and downloading the MATLAB projects and then presentations and WhatsApp support. Noted your point, Mr. EMC. Let me check. Thank you, Merlin. Thank you, Deepak. Thank you, Lokesh. Thank you, Dr. Ansal. Thank you, sir. Thanks for your valuable comment. So, please share your video feedback to my WhatsApp number. So please share your video feedback to my WhatsApp number. Sometime inertia block added also with the gear and then clutch. Yeah, you can add it. So please share your video feedback to my WhatsApp number. If you feel, if you want to add any more content and then if you feel this content is awesome, so please comment and as well as that, please share your video feedback. The electric rickshaw is just a three-wheel system. See, you can use the same methodology for the three-wheel system also. So, in the mechanical front-guided vehicle or back-guided vehicle, so that physical things only you are going to change it. Other all the things are same, similar one. So, only thing the aerodynamic area and then weight and then dimension. These three things only going to be changed. Thank you, participants. Thanks for your valuable comments. And if you feel this session give you some idea about this EV modeling, so please share your video feedback to my WhatsApp number 1-9840974408.